What are some of the most common misconceptions people have about a family with a kid like Nathaniel or people affected by disabilities?
There's probably a few. One I can think of, like, especially from when he was younger, is like people with kids the same age, like, would think that we didn't want to be included because Nathaniel wasn't like the other kids. Like that it would make me feel bad to see their kid, you know, succeeding or walking or feeding themselves or whatever. And, you know, that was a misconception for me because it didn't bother me. I was happy for other people and their kids and, you know, we just, it's too much trouble to go somewhere or we're embarrassed even by like him, you know, just jibber jabbering, you know, saying words out loud at whatever time that it comes to his mind, you know, and like, really, we just kind of get used to that, you know, like it really doesn't affect us at all, you know, anywhere we are, you know, like during a quiet time, you know, we may tell him shh or whatever, but I mean, out in public, like, you know, we're not embarrassed at all. And people might think, because I remember when he was born, people would say, what are you going to do now? And I thought, well, we're going to do what
we've always done.
Right. Yeah. We're going to go and do and go to church and go any place that we would have went if Nathaniel was quote unquote normal.
What kind of diet does the doctor recommend for Nathaniel and if he takes certain supplements for his health and well-being?
Right.